You say good morning. Say good morning. Good morning. Yeah, good morning. Burr, burr. Good morning. He said, good morning. Hey guys, so I started the vlog at like, which glasses am I wearing? Okay, I couldn't tell. I was like, why are they so reflective? My new glasses do that a lot. Sorry. I started the vlog today at like 4 a.m. and I've been like dragging butt, and now it's almost 4 p.m. Well, it's 3:30. And so I just picked up to start vlogging again. Jackson and I rested most of the morning because, as you can tell, he's probably extremely tired from waking up at 4. But he's been like going through some sleep problems. I don't think it's sleep regression. I noticed like they said that it looked like he had a back molar coming in already. Like when, before he even got this tooth he has now, he finally has one tooth, and I'll talk about it in the bump date that I re-record. I'm gonna record on Thursday his 8 month update, and then on his 9 month update, I'm gonna record it. But to save myself the trouble of a lot of extra work, I'm gonna edit them at the same time. But I wanna do them separately, like recording them's not hard. I wanna make sure I do them separately though, so don't leave anything out. And if I did one whole video I started thinking about, it would be really long, because my updates are always like 30 minutes long. So, I think he is teething again, and it's making his sleep weird. Like at night, he won't, like he wants me, he's trying to stand up, like, from the sitting position. He's so funny. Okay, at night, he wants me, like, when he goes to sleep, not necessarily, like, as long as I'm in the room, I feel like, and he can smell me or whatever spidey sense he has to tell I'm in the room, he's good. I have not moved him. We were talking about moving him into his nursery at 9 months, but I just don't think I'm going to be able to do it before 12 months. I know Justin's kind of ready, but I don't really understand why, because, like, Jackson doesn't wake him up at night. Like, you know, he's crying and stuff. So, but I just, prime example, if any of you follow Gabe and Jess, Jess Fam, it used to be Gabe and Jess. Y'all know she has, like, 7 kids. Like, 2 are stepkids, but she just had Addie with her new husband, and if y'all follow her story, y'all know that Addie had an emergency recently and she stopped breathing and she's in the hospital now. And so when Jess was posting pictures on Instagram and Facebook, because I follow her, I saw that, and she didn't say what was wrong, she just asked for prayers, and I automatically knew that Addie had stopped breathing. I knew because I've been through that. And I saw, like, the tests they were doing and stuff. And so I should have known not to watch the video. Well, I didn't think it would. I guess you could say it triggered me. I didn't think it would trigger me, but I watched it. And Justin usually ignores stuff, like, when I watch stuff on YouTube. But I could tell he was listening, too. And it just triggered me, like, hearing her talk about how she found her not breathing and she was lifeless and screaming for her husband, Chris, because, like, that one night that was, like, the worst, when Jackson stopped breathing at home, it was very, very similar. He was completely just lifeless. I could not get him to breathe, and I was screamed for Justin. And finally, I got him to breathe. So it was, like, trauma all over again. and so, you know, and I talked about, I kind of glazed over, like, all the, I kind of, like, went over them but didn't get into detail about all the stuff that happened in the hospital when he was born, how he'd stopped breathing there. When he stopped breathing there, it didn't have to do with GERD. It had to do with fluid in his lungs, I guess because he was a C-section baby and it didn't all get squeezed out when he was born. And also being a little early, he was what they called lazy, like babies born earlier or like more sleepy, and I don't know, like could come like lazy. So when he couldn't get it out, he just stopped breathing. And I remember freaking out, screaming for the nurse when that happened, and like being terrified, like just all those times he stopped breathing just came back to me because he hasn't done it in so long. So, I mean, it's been a few months since he did it, and like he hasn't had any like traumatic moments where I could not get him to breathe right away in a long time. So, but watching that video, like I didn't think it would, like seriously triggered me. And now I have this anxiety again. I've been waking up, like he's on a breathing monitor, but I still wake up like ever since I watched that video, it's gotten worse. Like I always check on him like a lot through the night. I don't ever sleep through the night, even if he does, because I always wake up at least once to check on him. And like since I watched that, like I keep checking on him. Last night at 3, I woke up and he has started rolling on his stomach. And I know from like working at preschools and daycares, state licensing would come, and if a baby was on their stomach, as long as they could roll themselves on their stomach, so licensing would flip them back to their back, and if they rolled themselves back to their stomach while licensing was there, the school didn't get written up. Because if you put a baby on its stomach that didn't put itself there, the school gets written up, because it's an unsafe sleep environment for kids. So I know once they can roll on their stomach, it's not a huge deal. Like, even licensing wouldn't wake him up and make him sleep on their back if he was in the school. But what freaks me out is he doesn't turn his head sometimes. He just puts his face flat in the mattress. Like, so that's why I keep his crib, like, empty. But I follow all the guidelines. But still, like, and he has a breathable, safe mattress, like, top of the line. But he still puts his face like this on the mattress. And I freak out when I find him like that. And last night, 3 a.m., I found him like that. And he was on the sleeping monitor. But as soon as I saw him face down like that, I saw the light was green. His vitals were fine. I still freaked out and rolled him. When I rolled him, he was like, oh, hi, Mom. I'm awake now. So I put him in bed and was rocking him. And he went back to sleep for like 45 minutes. But I didn't, because I was like, you know. And then he woke up at 4. So that was our night last night. I'm already been talking for almost 7 minutes, y'all. I'm sorry. I have a funny clip for y'all. I have to tell you the story first. And I wish I had saved the other snap. Days like today make me kind of wish I had a Snapchat for you guys. So I'm seriously, I don't know. I wish I had saved the snap so I could put it all in my vlog. So Jackson, like I said, has not been sleeping good in the earlier parts of the night when I would be making his food and doing stuff like that. So I hadn't made, he ran out of food yesterday, but I had some organic spinach and lentils, which is something I make for him as well. And he's used to it. He loves spinach. So it was spinach and lentils from Earth's Best, like baby food in a jar. And the only thing he's ever had in a jar or container that he really eats a lot is prunes. But usually everything else I make. There's a few fruits he's had that Crystal gave us that he liked. But vegetable wise, he's always just had what I make him. I put the stuff in a little dish and I started feeding it to him. He would not eat it. Like, he wouldn't eat it at all. And he spit it at me and started shaking his hand, and he started going like, blah, 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 blah. Like, he was yelling at me and baby blabber. And I was like, what the heck? Like, he was mad that I tried to give him something pre-made. Like, I don't know, like, he was being snobby. So I sent a snap, and I wish I had saved it of his, like, yelling at me and baby blabber about giving him pre-made food. Anyway, so I had to start making his food. And his favorite thing right now is organic carrots, raisins, and spinach. He really likes organic carrots and spinach together, but I recently added the raisins too, so I don't have to make prunes anymore. Organic raisins are just so much easier to find. So, I had to make him that while he was sitting in the high chair, and he was sitting there watching me like, Jackson, don't rip that. He's sitting there watching me like, make my food, woman. And then, he was I didn't get this in video, but he has started eating seaweed. Organic seaweed chips. They're not really chips. They're just dried like a certain way, so they're like light and crispy. So he's been eating those and he really likes them, and they're dried or whatever with a little sesame oil. So he has really been liking that. So I went and I made him, or I gave him some of that while I was making the food. And then I went and I sat down in front of him after I finished eating, and I was just talking to him and singing, and he kept going like trying to see if his food was ready yet. I'll insert the clip. He's watching the stove to see if his food's done cooking yet. So he's trying to pull the border off of his learning wall. So yeah, he was doing that. So anyway, if you follow me on Instagram, you probably saw my post about it. But it was just like, who, you were like on a boss baby level, like a million today. Like, he is in full boss baby mode. It is crazy. I need to find the boss baby book. I think it's right here. Show you guys. It's actually a really cute book. This is the book. This is Boss Baby. From the moment Boss Baby arrived, it was obvious he was the boss. It's just really cute. And he put mom and dad on around the clock schedule. I know, it's super cute. Anyways, that's the Boss Baby book. So when y'all hear me talk about Boss Baby, that's why my family calls him that. But he was like in full Boss Baby mode today. So yeah, I've got to go get Justin soon. And then Chelsea said she sent something to my P.O. box. So I'm going to go check it. And yeah. I think today's vlog is mostly going to be me sitting here talking. Sorry, guys. I mean, I hope you don't mind. Some of you guys say you like that, but I don't know. Yeah. When he goes down, though, I have so much to do. Like, Justin is going to have to, like, Justin's really good about, if he wakes up crying and Justin goes in there, he's like, okay, and he goes to sleep, like, again faster. But if I go in there, he's like, mama, mama, and, like, rubs my head. Wants me to hold him, and it's fine because I love that. And he's not gonna be this little for long. It's all going by so fast. So usually I'm just like, okay, I'll stay in here with you for 3 hours and hold you while I could be cooking you food. Like, it's fine usually, but I've got to make him food and stuff and like do some stuff tonight. So Justin's gonna have to help me with that. The post office, and I got something from Chelsea, and like as soon as I saw the bag, I was like, I'm just gonna open it now. He's so grumpy. The bag. Okay. This is so cute! It's funny because Chelsea's like, you probably already have it. I don't have this. I've never seen this. Oh my god. Look how cute these jammies are. Look, they have Saturn and rocket ships. Jackson, look. You don't have these. These are cute. And it glows in the dark. Do you see these? Okay, sweet. Those are so stinking cute. Thank you, Chelsea.
I was excited about them.
He's like, new space jammies. Thank you so much, girl. Oh my god. I want to like put these in the dark and watch them glow. We actually don't have these.
And now we'll never lose Jackson in the dark.
We'll never lose him in the dark. Thank you so much, girl. She is so, so sweet. Oh my gosh, you are so spoiled this week. Madge sent you clothes and Chelsea sent you clothes. And you're just over here like, you're such a well-dressed baby. So tonight was the night. Or today was the day that I had all that crazy drama at the Dollar Tree, even though y'all saw that video like a couple of days ago. Anyway, so I never found what I needed. I'm trying to put stuff together for his swim coach, and I'm going to show you guys in a minute what I did, or what I'm going to do. But it's so frustrating. I know they've had skewers like that you would do like shish kebabs on. I've bought them there before. Or bought them there before, not bought in. Is that even a word? That's not a word. Heather, what the heck? Okay, so I bought them there before. And they had the box for, like, like, you know, styrofoam balls and stuff, like in the craft section, like you would build planets with or use for flower arrangements. Like, you know, like science projects or flower arrangements. Currently, that's the only two things you can use them for in my mind. I needed that for this, and they didn't have that either. So I just got an eye full of drama, and that was it. So after we put Jackson to bed, we caught up a little bit on This Is Us. We still have like 4 episodes to be completely caught up. And then I'm trying to catch up on The Bachelor slowly. I don't ever really have time for TV, and I don't really miss it. Like, it doesn't bother me, you know? But everyone keeps talking about This Is Us and The Bachelor. I didn't even think I was going to watch this season, but it's turning out to be good. So anyways, that was my night. I'm going to show you guys what I'm making for his swim coach. And then I'm going to end the vlog. So if I can get this bucket to hold all the weight, I don't know if it will. I'm going to use this, and I'm going to put her name on here in vinyl. And then, so I'm going to make it like everything I have. Some of the stuff I have is upstairs, like the grass I'm going to be talking about. And I have a few like decorative picks that have glitter hearts on them that are really cute that I'm going to stick in there. But it's basically going to be like a candy bouquet with a Starbucks gift card and one of Jackson's Valentine's Day pictures. But I got this and these. I just got like a bunch of random kind of candy because you never know what people like. I got a little thing of chocolates. I got Twix. Justin. And I got this little bag of these Lindor chocolates. So I'm going to have, like, here's the bucket, and it's going to be on like little sticks to make it like a bouquet of candy. Y'all can kind of envision it, right? Okay, you envisioning it? And then somewhere in there, there'll be the little decorative picks with hearts, and then the little decorative grassy stuff to cover, like whatever I put in here, the foam or whatever to hold the picks. And then I'm gonna stick a Starbucks gift card on there too. And what was the other thing? Oh, a picture of Jackson. Hopefully will fit somewhere on here. One of his Valentine's Day pictures, or I'm making a Valentine's Day card. So that is what I'm making his swim coach. Okay, so I'm gonna end the vlog. That's when I am making his swim coach. It might seem kind of like strange to some people, I guess, maybe. But I was a teacher, and no matter when I was like a teacher or worked in a daycare or a preschool teacher, it was like, it was always nice to get little gifts, like not even things that cost money, but just little things from the parents. Oh no, my cup thing is down here. Or that's yours. Little things from the parents, just kind of like, you know, just a little, we appreciate you kind of thing. And Jackson loves the swim coach. She's very, very sweet. She's always patient with him. And so she's very patient with Liam too when he's having a rough day. So I just wanted her to know she's appreciated and wanted to get her a little something for Valentine's Day. Anyways, okay, I'm done the vlog. We'll see you guys later. Bye.